Hi, welcome back. We're here with Sinead talking about Azure Network Security. Sinead, can you share with us some of the common use cases of network security services on Azure?
I think we've multiple services for different use cases.
Yes.
So I would say first use case is how do you protect the application from common attacks?
Right.
And those attacks can be in the form of a denial of service attack.
Right.
They can be in the form of a SQL injection attack.
Mm-hmm.
They can be a cross-site scripting. So you really want to look at, when you look at your application delivery, you have to look at what service am I going to use to protect it.
Right.
And so that's the very first use case I would suggest we look at. And that's where our WAF and DDoS service really come in to play protecting that application.
Right. And how about restricting access to resources within the corporate network or even on the cloud? What would our customers use?
Usually, our customers would use a combination of network segmentation, and that's
right.
where they would use our software-defined networking capabilities.
Yes.
And they would also sort of use sort of a hub and spoke model to set up the environment to set up their boundaries, if you will. And then they would use Azure Firewall to enforce those communication patterns and restrict the access.
That's
so they might be like front-end application can talk to back-end application,
right.
or this app. All internet traffic needs to go through the firewall because I want to have control. I want it all logged and audited, and I want it restricted. Or you might say, this specific resource cannot communicate with the internet,
right.
but it does need to get its code, so it does need to get to GitHub, or
right.
it needs to go to Windows Update to get its update. So it's no internet, but just some access.
Yeah.
And so that's really about how you restrict access and also how you centrally kind of govern the traffic flow. So,
We have also heard from our customers about controlling and governing traffic flows within their network and also in the cloud. Can you share with us your perspective of what they should be doing?
I would say it's a combination
right.
of, again, depending on their security risk profile and their network architecture. But for sure, we would say, first of all, for your developers, they will need to use network security groups and
right.
they will want to use VNet, a good VNet design.
Yes.
And some customers are sort of funny. They'll organize their VNets by, these are my green VNets, my red VNets, my blue VNets. And then they'll be like, oh, blue can't talk to green, but green can talk to red. So some
right.
customers are like that.
Yes.
Then other customers are more like, oh, this is business group one.
Right.
Business group one has this VNet, and business group two has this VNet. And
right.
then they have a shared a central IT group who has the shared service VNet. And then
yes.
they are doing a combination of giving them
yeah.
some control to do some things sort of in their VNet. And then everything then goes through the shared service environment. So we see customers
nice.
Mixing and matching the models. And this is where kind of Azure Firewall really fits in, is to help customers sort of, depending on their architecture, support their desire to control and govern the flows.
Right, and all these capabilities are all within the Azure Firewall services.
That's correct.
Yeah,
that's correct.
Great. And another thing that we've heard from a lot from our customers is about data exfiltration, right? They are trying to prevent and stop data exfiltration within their network. Can you share your perspective in terms of, what should they be doing?
Yeah, there's a combination. It can happen. Sometimes
right.
the exfiltration happens from the web app when it gets penetrated. And so putting a WAF in front of it and using DDoS is sort of, often the DDoS attacks, they often start as a DDoS attack and they're trying to actually detect where is the app vulnerable.
Right.
And then sometimes, so I would say first thing is you want to protect the app with WAF and DDoS. And then the second thing that happens is they look at their data store. And they're looking at, well, who's got access to it? You have
right.
to lock down the access controls. And so that's
right.
where the combination of having the right software-defined network model
right.
so that you can, who's allowed to talk
yeah,
to whom, and
the,
and
yeah.
then use the firewall to lock down the access methods, and
that's
then
great.
Be able to log and audit it and use some of the controls, like we have service endpoints, so for
right.
the PaaS service controls as well. So
okay.
the combination of good software-defined networking capabilities and Azure
right.
Firewall can really help you have a good model for protecting
great.
Data exfiltration.
Yeah, that's great. Yeah, so just to put it together, today we have talked about the Azure Firewall, the Azure Web Application Firewall, and the DDoS. I just want to get a perspective in terms of how we put it all together and how will customers be using all these products together within the Azure network.
One thing that Azure Networking has is a very nice, they call it the virtual data center.
Yes.
And it's just a reference architecture model.
That's
and
right.
It's also out on GitHub. It has scripts. And it's just a reference model to show you how you might construct a hub and spoke model in the cloud,
right,
or how you might layer in PaaS services. And it's a reference architecture for a customer to start with.
That's
and
right.
Then what you do as part of that model is most customers then would have their security services in the shared service VNet in
right,
that model.
Right.
And then, so it kind of starts with traffic coming in from the internet, and they sort of call that northbound traffic.
Right.
And that's where you'd start with your first line of defense is DDoS.
Yes.
And then the second line is generally either the Azure firewall or the web application firewall. And
right,
again, depending on the traffic pattern, if it's inbound HTTP, you'll put a WAF.
Okay.
If it's inbound any other port or protocol, you put
right,
Azure firewall.
Okay.
And
right,
similarly, so that's sort of northbound. And if you've traffic going out to the internet, you'll have Azure Firewall there as well.
Okay.
So that's sort of the northbound pattern. Another one would be the southbound pattern, which would be traffic coming from on-premise. And
yes,
that would come in either over express route or virtual WAN. And again, you would flow it through the firewall so that you can lock down the access controls. And then customers say, well, what about east-west? You
yes,
know, this app, you know, or even within the spoke, like I want the web, I only want the front end to talk to the back end. And again, you can use Azure Firewall and network
right,
security groups
together.
To do the east-west segmentation as well.
Right. So is it easy to turn on these services when they deploy their applications?
Yeah, what's really nice about these cloud-native services is that you've lots of different ways to turn them on. If
right,
you go through the portal, it's super, it's just click-click, and then 3 minutes as your firewall's up and running.
Right.
Or you can use command line, you can
right,
use Python, it really is up to you to deploy it.
Okay.
And
right,
a lot of customers, we see them even script it all. And so
right,
they sort of are really using the DevOps model of they rebuild the environment and they rebuild these services on the fly, or they use Terraform to
okay,
do it. So you kind of it's very, very easy
it's
to use them,
all,
and that's
yeah,
one of the kind of benefits of these cloud native services.
And there are different APIs that they can actually utilize to actually code this and make this more consistent across their network.
Yeah, that's what they
yeah,
love. They want again, they're all embracing this infrastructure as code model.
Yes.
And then, you know, if a disaster happens, it's very easy to rebuild. And so that whole model is sort of very, very supported by these services. They're all ARM templates, and they all can be deployed using your code
right,
framework of choice.
Okay. Thank you, Sinead. That's all we have today. If you'd like to know more about Azure Network Security, go to aka.ms/Azure Network Security. Thanks for watching.